Okay, so we're back with the next stage of the six-stage process, six steps to the winning pitch. And now we're going to talk about the concept of team. Okay, Justin, so nowadays, I think in most complex sale is there's two things. Is number one, you're normally rarely selling exclusively on your own, right? You're normally part of a group and you're rarely selling to an individual either.
Right. Certainly, there are many occasions where you may pitch on your own. The kinds of pitches that I get involved with are usually pitches where there are multiple people. If you can get more than one person to that pitch, I have found it to be very impressive to a prospect when you walk in there and they realize that they're not dealing with one individual, they're dealing with a team. The kinds of pitches that I work on, which would be for consultants, often accountants who are going into pitch for multi-million dollar deals, they are going in sometimes with five, six people. Mm-hmm. And John, this really, again, almost everything in the pitch to win process happened through direct experience, realizing how important this was. From the start, if you told me that team was going to be a part of the formula, I would have said, well, what for? It was only through starting to work with these high-level teams. So for instance, as I say, a lot of the work that I do is with accountants. Yes, they too need a pitch. They got to bring it in. And what would happen is these guys would be partners coming in for a big pitch, coming in from different parts of the world. You might have a partner from the States, one from Europe, from South Africa, and they're coming together, they're going to work together for a week before this big pitch. And I realized what was happening is they were often highly stressed because they're nervous, and we'll talk about what I call big pitch temperament later. They were highly stressed, and when people are stressed, they tend to rub each other the wrong way. And I noticed that there was this often sometimes simmering conflict between the partners that would negatively impact their performance. And it was very clearly apparent to me that you only have to think to yourself, if I was choosing a team to come and into my business, I'd want to know that that team was cohesive, that that team was going to work well together. And let me tell you something, people, they don't always register it consciously, but you can pick, hey, listen, we've all been with a couple who are not openly fighting in front of you, but you just know these guys aren't so happy, you know, and you just get a gut sense that they probably, and it's subtle, right? It could just be the body language turned away from one another, or there's a slight curling of the lip or rolled eye. And again, you might even figure it consciously, but you're not kind of feeling the love, right? Mm-hmm. Well, guess what? Clients feel that as well. When you walk in, they can feel the connections between you. Now, if you want to look at the evidence behind this and why they are in fact right to judge you partly on how cohesive you are as a team, beautiful study on 360 business units found the number one factor determining the success of a team was how the team members felt about one another. Mm. If team members like one another, there's high affinity, you tend to have high performance. If there's low affinity, you tend to have low performance. Simple as that. Now, sometimes people say, well, you know, what if I just don't like someone? What if, well, yeah, listen, most people who get married love each other. And most people who get married, or at least nearly half of people who get married, get divorced. Mm-hmm. And that presumably because they don't like each other anymore. Well, that's the same people, which tells us that it's not the people, it's what we're doing. Mm-hmm. And so in the pitch to win process, what I will do with, particularly when we're going into big pitches, we'll do for half a day, we just do effectively a team build.
Yeah.
And I cannot tell you the difference before and after that. Just the way that the team just wants you. There's not difficult stuff. I mean, there's specific ways to build team cohesion. We don't have a whole lot of time to go into the detail now, but it's like giving people an opportunity to express appreciation to one another. That's a key way to build affinity. Sharing personal stories that have nothing to do with work. We all know people do business with people that they know, trust, and like. If I don't know you, if I don't know what you're struggling with, I don't know what you're going through, I'm not going to be there for you. I'm not going to empathize with you, right? So it's just giving them a chance to really get to know each other, build some liking through appreciation. And I cannot tell you the difference in performance after that. It's not intuitive for most people to think, oh, we're preparing for a pitch. Let's get the team right. But I see it again and again. It's an absolutely critical key. Now, if you are pitching alone, a lot of that applies to how you create a strong sense of team with the potential client that you have. What I always like to say is, you know, we say if you've got a really strong relationship with a service provider, let's say your electrician, and somebody needs an electrician, you'd say, hey, talk to my guy, right?
Yeah.
And that's somebody really trust and connect with. So also this part of the program, we look at how can we create a sense for that prospect that you will be a part of their team, that you won't just be a service provider, you won't just be an external salesperson, but you're actually going to gel, you're going to connect, and that's about the rapport building and the connection. So the team is both, if you're pitching as a team and also with that client, to give them the sense that they will be part of your team or you'll be part of theirs.
Yeah, excellent. And I think the other part is, I love that because I think there's nothing more off-putting when a team comes in to pitch to you, right? You know, maybe there's two or three or four people and they are jumping over each other and they're getting in each other's way, that they haven't spent the time in advance actually defining what each person's role is going to be, which part of the presentation they're going to handle, if they're going to handle the financial question, somebody else, all of that. When it's choreographed, it's beautiful. When it's not, yeah, it can be disastrous. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's interesting, and thank you for that, because when I talk team, I almost always talk exclusively in terms of cohesion, but you're quite right. That's also a big part of it. When you're going out as a team, you need to choreograph that. I'm not saying you don't want some spontaneity, sure, and, you know, you want to be conversational and let people pick things up, but you're quite right. I don't know that if the prospect asks this question, that is my area or that I need to refer over, and, you know, even the seating position, you know, a lot of what pitch is about is dealing with nervousness. And if you don't know, the choreography of this pitch, it can be very unsettling. So absolutely, the coordination of the team members in the pitch is critical too.
Excellent.